Now here we are to have a look at another offering from the Fender stable. This time it's an acoustic electric guitar by the name of Starcaster. There's no model number in this, it just says Starcaster Natural. So it's a dreadnought body with a cutaway so that you can reach the upper frets, and the action is low enough to actually make this worthwhile having. It's a very comfortable guitar to play. There's a pickup which you can't see, but it's underneath the bridge saddle here, and on the side of the guitar you can just make out the preamp, the volume, bass, middle and treble, and an external battery compartment there, so you don't need to be like James Herriot at the vet and have your hand in awkward places. As you can hear, a nice rich sound to this guitar. Now, how does it sound as we go up the necks? How's the intonation? The words spot on, spring to mind. Very good indeed. It's a high gloss finish, which from my point of view is the only downside the guitar has. Construction wise, as I said, it's a solid top guitar, which immediately puts you out of the basic range of guitars. It's a solid top guitar, very sturdily built. It's quite a heavy guitar, and it has a good projection. And so on. And this particular one's had a real battering, and it hasn't developed any cracks anywhere, which is a good thing. So it's it'll do with some rough handling on the road. Now what I'll do is I'll turn off the mic and I'll turn up the pickup. So there you can hear both the pickup and the acoustic quality, both of which are very good. I'm very pleased with them indeed. It's got gold plated machine heads up the top, which are, flip them over, standard enough style, but they're fully enclosed and I've had no trouble with them at all, no jamming or sticking in any way. Now, the name Starcaster, there's a certain amount of confusion going around here, and it's all of Fender's doing. There are, to the best of my knowledge, at least three generations of guitar that have used the name Starcaster. Currently, as we're making this in 2013, there's a range of acoustics and electrics going around the various chain stores, and they're budget models. This particular guitar is some 4 or 5 years old. It's from the previous generation. This is a more upmarket instrument. The solid top and the gold-plated machine heads tend to suggest that. Quality-wise, for those of you that know the guitars, it's very similar to a Takamine G-series guitar, which incidentally were made in the Yamaha plant. There's a tie-up between Takamine and Yamaha, which I discovered one day in the music shop I was working in. I just sold a Yamaha acoustic, went through to the back shop, opened up a pack of four new ones, and took out the first one, unwrapped it to find Yamaha at the top. Yamaha inside the side hole, and on the scratch plate, Takamine. makes you wonder, doesn't it? Yes. Who are we making guitars for today, folks? That was what it was like, yes. So, yes, there's a tie-up there. And that's a compliment. If it's like a Takamine, it's good. So there we are. That's the Starcaster guitar. Thoroughly recommend them. What the new ones are like, I don't know. But if you've got one, let me know. Put a wee comment in the comment box and let me know whether you think it's heaven or hell or somewhere in between.